Nowadays, developers have many avenues to get games made and published so that everyone can play more than ever before. The field of battle is massive in this indie arena, with dozens of small-scale titles in any given genre vying for your purchase every single year. It can be fun to jump in and try games you know almost nothing about, and there are a lot of them you can do that with. Oftentimes, it seems you get a dud, but sometimes you find something really worth singing about. And you know what? Despite its flaws, Rise and Shine is a game I'll look back on and say it was worth it. I'm Kevin with the TrueGaming Network, and this is my review for Rise and Shine. The first thing that strikes you about this game is the visuals, and they're honestly the best thing about this game. Every single set piece is unique and absolutely beautiful. There were quite a few times I'd stop and just look to admire the quality of the art, and that's something I almost never do. Animation goes hand in hand with good visuals, and the game succeeds there too. You know, it's just a complete visual package, and it's constantly enjoyable play simply because of the visuals alone. Now, the second thing that strikes you about the game is that the developers clearly love Dark Souls. The fact that you have infinite respawns is something the game throws in your face constantly, and you'll use them a lot, as you're going to constantly die. Literally every time I walked into a new area, I was met with some new enemy or mechanic that killed me. I had a lot of fun discovering something new and working out how to overcome it over the course of a few deaths, you know, at the beginning at least. It was really fun to be constantly surprised, and while by the end of the game I was pretty tired of dying constantly, I still believe it's something the game did quite well. The gameplay sees you doing two things, really. First, it's a running gun. Combat is a bit simple. It revolves around taking cover and then shooting enemies with either regular or electric bullets. That's pretty much it, and it's a good thing the game is short, or this would have become very stale very quickly. There are occasionally enemies, well actually there's just one enemy that requires you to use grenades to kill it, otherwise you're just using bullets over and over. I'd really have liked some more variety in the, you know, everyday combat. It feels like there's a lot of promise here that just wasn't realized. That said, there were, however, some really cool boss battles, and I did enjoy those. You were constantly moving, constantly figuring out new strategies, reacting to the enemies. That was great, and it did show that the combat can be really fun. Like I said, I just wish the rest of the game matched up with the quality of those boss battles. The other half of the gameplay involves puzzles. Now, personally, I hate puzzles with a passion. Seriously, I do not enjoy getting stuck. But Rise and Shine didn't frustrate me. The puzzles are interspersed with combat and other set pieces, and each one is fairly simple but unique. If you're the type of player who wants to sit and think constantly, these are not going to be for you. But if you're just looking for little puzzles to spice up the gameplay here and there and give you a break from running and gunning, the puzzles here do just that. I enjoyed them. I'm glad that they are in the game. I think they make it a lot better. Sadly, there's not a whole lot else to do. There are a few types of collectibles you can find. Chests will give you extra ammo permanently, which is great, and then there's little floating circles that do absolutely nothing. I ran through the game and found about half of these circles without too much effort, but looking through a second time, I have no idea where the rest of them could be. So if you like collectibles, I guess they'll be enjoyable. Otherwise, you're picking out a guide and, you know, that's okay, I guess. There's also a second difficulty called Iron Man, where if you die, your save is lost. In a game where you constantly die, this is obviously frustrating. That said, it's a difficulty for Elite, so that would be okay, except playing Iron Man also erases your collectible progress, which really, really sucks. To me, the game's story was also a miss. It's full to the brim of blatant video game references I honestly found annoying. The hero is controlled by the guides, who are you. The game would constantly break the fourth wall subtly with comments and quips that really took me out of the immersion. Within the world itself, you'll find references to all kinds of video games, from generic RPGs to Mario. I'm sure some players could find something to appreciate here, but for me, it was kind of just wishing that the beautiful visuals were accompanied by a nice story that I could really get behind. Instead, it was simply over the top, and maybe the best word for it is just raucous. It was too much and too in your face. Overall, the game only took me about 3 hours to beat, though there was still a huge amount of gamer score left unlocked. My 3 hours was mostly enjoyable, and it was definitely worth playing, at least until the very end when I was met with that huge difficulty spike and spent over an hour in the final section of the game, which is just two fights. That was a bit of a mood killer. But looking back, Rise and Shine is a game I'm glad I played. I'm going to give it 3 stars out of 5. I think fans of running guns will find a lot to like here, and plenty of challenge in the Iron Man difficulty. The visuals are beautiful, and they're worth seeing. I'm not sure it's going to mobilize a lot of love from everyone, but it's definitely a fun game, and I'm glad I played it. I'm Kevin with the True Gaming Network, and this has been my review for Rise and Shine. If you liked what you saw, please like and subscribe. We really appreciate it. Also, please feel free to leave a comment. I'd love to hear what you have to say. Until next time, I bid you all farewell.